everyone. Welcome to Guiding Through Education. Last class we have seen about ecological succession, and this class we are going to see the ecological pyramids. So if we talk about ecological pyramids, what is ecological pyramids? It is the graphical representation. We can define ecological pyramid as graphical representation of organisms that participate in the food chain, right? So this is what we can define ecological pyramids. When we draw the graphical representation, here I have attached the diagram. You see, this is a graphical representation, right? The food chain, entire food chain we have. See, if you see, grass eaten up by mice, eaten up by snake, eaten up by eagle, right? So this graphical presentation, this food chain, the graphical presentation, if you present it in this form, we call it ecological pyramid. Since graph is in the form of pyramid, so we call it pyramid, right? So what is your primary producer? Here it will be plants, right? Then here it will be mice. If I show you for this food chain example, so here it will be mice, then here it will be snake, here it will be eagle or vultures, whatever, right? So this way, when we represent the organism, when we represent graphically the organisms that participates in the food chain, we call that ecological pyramid. So this is the representation. So if we see the definition, the graphic representation of the trophic structure. Trophic structure means what? Each of the organisms that participate in the trophic level, we call them trophic structure. Organism in various trophic level. Now what is trophic level? Say suppose grass eaten up by mice, eaten up by snake, eaten up by vulture. So if you see this, each, this is one organism, this is one, this is one, this is one. So each of this organism, what we call? We call them trophic levels. Clear? So the graphical representation of the trophic structure organism in various level of a food chain is called ecological pyramid. The food or energy relationship among organisms at different trophic levels can be expressed in terms of number, biomass or energy. The organisms that participate in the food chain, we can draw the graphical representation in terms. This is a supposed food chain, right? So here you see how many organisms are participated, how many organisms are present at each trophic level. So when we represent, when we try to define the number of organisms that participate in a food chain, we call that pyramid of number. What we call? We call that pyramid of number. And what is pyramid of biomass? The amount of biomass generated by the utilization of the energy from each of this trophic level, we call it biomass. And energy, you say grass is giving 10% energy to mice, 10% to snake. The 10% of energy that travels from one or trophic level to another in a food chain. When we represent the energy structure, we call that pyramid of energy. So this graphical representation of organisms participating in a food chain, we call the ecological pyramid. And this ecological pyramid is how many types? Three types. What are the three types? Pyramid of number. Yes. Second is the pyramid of biomass. And third is the pyramid of energy. Right? These are the three pyramids. The expression assumes the shape of a pyramid where the base represents the producers or the first trophic level, while apex represents the tertiary or top level consumer. So if I draw the chain pyramid here, you see this is what is the grass eaten up by mice, eaten up by snake, eaten up by vulture. So if I write it like this, here grass, mice, snake, vulture. Now here you see the base, the trophic level. If you see this, see here, the base represents the producers. This is a base. This is one, base. And who is present at the base? Grass. So what is grass? It is a producer. So base represents producers, right? And apex, if you see, this is the apex. This is what? Top consumers or tertiary level consumer. So we call this what? Consumer. Which level? Tertiary level consumer. Primary, secondary, tertiary. Got it? So this is what is a graphical representation. Each trophic level represents a functional level, not only one species in particular. So it is a functional level. How functionally they are active, we represent them in the form of a graph, and that is what we call ecological pyramid. We see this is an ecological pyramid. See, T, butterfly, rat, snake, eagle. Clear? So this is one way. And understood, grass eaten up by grasshopper, sparrow, owl, then eagle. Clear? So if you say the number of organisms are more at the base than number of organisms at the top. Clear? And also energy always transferred from producers to consumer. Clear? Type of ecological pyramid. If we see ecological pyramid, it is of three type: pyramid of number, pyramid of biomass, and pyramid of energy. If we talk about pyramid of numbers, it is a graphical representation of the number of individuals present at each trophic level in a food chain of an ecosystem. So in a food chain, suppose grass eaten up by butterfly, mice, snake, vulture. Right. So how many organisms are present? The number of individuals that present at each trophic level. At this level, how many individuals are present? At each level, how many individuals are present? So this graphical representation of number of individuals present at each trophic level, we call it pyramid of number. Pyramid of numbers can be upright or inverted depending on the number of producers. It can be upright. Upright means like this. And upright will happen when the number of producers are more compared to the number of consumers. And it can be inverted. Inverted means what? The number of consumer is more than number of producers. Clear? So it can be upright or inverted. For example, in a grassland ecosystem, the pyramid of number is upright. If we talk about grassland ecosystem, the pyramid of number is upright. Upright means like this. So the base level producer is more in number. So it is upright. In this type of food chain, the number of producers, plants, is followed by number of herbivores, mice, which in turn is followed by the number of secondary consumers, snake, and tertiary carnivores, eagles. Right? So hence the number of individuals at the producer level will be maximum, while the number of individuals present at the top carnivores will be less. So number of individual present at the base is high than the number of organism present at the top. Clear? So this is what is the pyramid of number. So here producers are grass. So if you see, this is a pyramid of number, isn't it? This is what? This is a pyramid of number. See, this is producers. This is primary consumer, secondary consumer, and tertiary consumer. So producers are grass, small in size and large in number, hence they occupy the first trophic level. The primary consumers are rats, occupying the second trophic level. It is worthwhile to know that rats are less in number than grass. That's why they are in the secondary consumer. Because you see, the number is less. And if you see grass, this occupy this much. But if you see its primary consumer, it is less. Secondary consumers are snakes, which occupy the third trophic level, and they are lesser in number than rats. That's why you say they are lesser in number than rats. And tertiary consumers are eagle, which is more lesser in number than the tertiary, or you can say secondary consumer. Clear? So the graph is upright. Coming to pyramid of biomass. In this particular type of ecological pyramid, each level takes into account the amount of biomass produced by each trophic level. The pyramid of biomass is also upright, except for that observed in oceans, where large number of zooplanktons depend on relatively small number of phytoplanktons. Normally, the pyramid of biomass is upright for terrestrial organisms, but it is inverted for oceans. This is upright. And this is, you see, inverted for oceans, right? So where large number of consumers is more compared to producers, and here producers is more compared to consumer. It represents total number of biomass, mass or weight of biological material present in each trophic level. Considering the example of a forest ecosystem, there is steady decrease in a biomass from the lower trophic level to higher trophic level. The producers contribute a major amount of the biomass. The next trophic level are herbivores, insect and birds, and the carnivores, snake, foxes. The top of the trophic level consists of very few tertiary consumers whose biomass is very low. The pyramid is given. See here. This is a upright pyramid of biomass in terrestrial ecosystem. See, this is grass. 100 kg biomass, right? This is more, yes or no, compared to this herbivores which is having 100 kg. Primary carnivore is 10 kg, top carnivore 1 kg. This is what? Biomass. This is what? Biomass, weight, right? So here the more biomass is present or the more biomass is in producers. So here producer occupies the base level than the consumer or top carnivores, right? But if we talk about aquatic ecosystem or oceans, it is quite different. Here the producers are less in number, 4 g/m², and then herbivores, those eating these plants, it is 8 g/m², and carnivores, right? So it is both upright and inverted. This is upright and this is what? Inverted. Clear? That's all about pyramid of biomass. If we talk about pyramid of energy is the only type of ecological pyramid which is always upright, as the energy flow in a food chain is unidirectional. See, energy always flows from grass to deer to lion. It always flows in this way. It never flows backward. From lion, grass is not getting energy, right? Only from grass, lion is getting energy. So as energy is unidirectional, energy is flowing in only one direction. We called it what? We also called it unidirection. As energy is flowing only in one direction, so the energy, ecological pyramid, it is upright. Clear? At every successive trophic level, there is a heavy loss of energy, almost 90% in the form of heat. Thus, at each trophic level, only 10% is transferred. Hence, there is a sharp decrease in energy at each and every successive trophic level as we move from producers to consumers. So, what is happening? Suppose this grass is producing 100 joule of energy. Now, from 100 joule, only 10% will be transferred to deer. So, 100 joule of 10% is how much? 10 joule. Now, if you say 10 joule of 10% is 1. So, what about the remaining 90%? Remaining 90% will be loss, will get loss in the environment in the form of heat energy. And this energy is energy always flows in unidirectional. So, we get that pyramid of energy as always upright. Clear? Ecosystem regulation. Ecosystem tries to regulate. See, your ecosystem itself tries to resist to any environmental stress. It always resists to any environmental stress which tries to disturb the normal ecosystem and maintain the ecosystem environment in equilibrium. So this property we call it homeostasis. So what is homeostasis? Yes, it is the resistance or ecosystem resistance towards environmental stress. Resistance of an ecosystem towards environmental stress, we call it homeostasis. However, this system can show this tolerance or resistance only within a maximum and minimum range, which is known as homeostatic plateau. Within this range, if any stress tries to cause a deviation, then the system has its own mechanism to counteract this deviation, which are known as negative feedback mechanisms. These negative feedback mechanisms try to bring the system back to its ideal conditions. But if the stress is too high and beyond the range of homeostatic plateau, then another type of mechanism known as positive feedback mechanism starts operating and accelerates the deviation. So this kind of mechanisms take the system away from the ideal conditions and leads to environmental disorders. So ecosystem regulation, always ecosystems tries to resist any kind of environmental stress that disturbs the normal ecosystem and maintain the equilibrium of the environment. And this is what we call homeostasis. So with this, I would like to end the class today. Next session, we will start. We'll deal with the types of ecosystem. Thank you, everyone.